joint workshop activity. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm happy to be here today. Akshay Patra is an organization which is one of its kind in the world. And as you know, they provide crores of meals to children who, in the absence of these meals, would probably not go to school. This is a huge service, and the way they do it is in itself a miracle. And I thank Akshay Patra for this. It is a matter of concern that a large number of children are malnourished. As the head of the World Bank, who dropped in to see us, was saying, he said that he himself is a scientist, a doctor, and number one in his priority anywhere in the world is getting rid of malnutrition. He said everything else comes later, development, companies, factories, agriculture, everything is later. Before everything, it has to be children. And he said that his main problem that he saw was stunting. And stunting meant not just small growth, but the absence of the development of neurons. And he said, if by the age of two, a child is malnourished, then those neurons don't form. So even if you feed them enormously later, and they grow and they become, they will never be completely normal. They will always be, they will always be slightly less intelligent, because the neurons haven't developed fully. So he urged us to look at this. Now, when I took over this ministry, I'm now going off script. When I took over this ministry, we have in this ministry the largest program in the world. We feed 9 poor children, pregnant lactating mothers. These are our beneficiaries. Now, the scale of this program can be understood from the fact that there are 14 lakh Anganwadi workers, centers, which cover each and every habitation in the country. These are manned by about 25 lakh Anganwadi workers and helpers who reach out to these 9 poor children. And these Anganwadi work centers were created about 40 years ago to address the issue of malnutrition through a variety of services. And this includes feeding children below 3 years of age, providing take-home rations to children from 3 to 6 years, educating and feeding pregnant and lactating mothers about and educating them for good nutritional and hygiene practices. The problem is that it simply didn't work. And it didn't work for some reasons. So if we look back on it, every minister, every government has tried their best to grapple with this issue. And the Anganwadi workers, when they came in, were more or less volunteers who were getting a stipend. But then it became a salary, chalte-chalte, even though it even technically is not a salary now. But as salaries go, providing them a salary put us back by 18,000 crores, just salary-wise. But it wasn't enough, or it isn't enough even now, for each Anganwadi worker who gets 3,000 rupees, and the helpers get 1,500. So this has led to massive unionization, and it has also led to another regrettable problem, and that is the disappearance of rations meant for children by Anganwadi workers who believe that since they're underpaid, they are entitled to pinch as much food as they can in lieu of a better pay. And this now has become so ingrained. But let's just suppose, so I started trying to grapple with this. So we offered them, since I couldn't increase the pay, we offered them incentives. We offered them promotions, which till then were closed off. Now we are offering them, I think, gratuity or something. We are offering them other things that we could. We then also tried to make sure that we could see whether they were feeding children or not. In Assam alone, they found that 9 lakh children were non-existent. They were just taking the money for each child, and those children didn't exist. And I'm sure that if we multiply this by all our UTs and states, we would find millions of children that simply were never fed or didn't exist, and food is going in their name to other pockets. So we gave a few of them on a pilot basis cell phones, so that those cell phones could be, they had to take pictures and return them to us. And the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation devised our software on how we could monitor the program. The problem is, the monitoring of the program also doesn't make much sense, because the food itself is not good. We give them a combination of wheat, which is 2 years old, rice, which has really been kept forever and is not very valuable in terms of nutrients. We give them oil, sugar, and that pili dal, which is about the cheapest dal that you can get, and again, it's not very valuable. So how, and they're supposed to mix and match these five ingredients into things that are edible. Now, I have been going around these last 3 years, and sometimes by informing them beforehand, sometimes just landing up, as I did in Himachal. And we have found really across the board in the Anganwadi system, we found bad food. In Himachal, we found pakoras, which were bought in lieu of whatever healthy food from the local pakora wala, after he'd finished feeding everything, anything that was left over from the previous day. Then in Tamil Nadu, we just found inedible food, inedible, made very cleanly, very beautifully. And we could not object to the way that it was made. The only point was that it was inedible. We found in Madhya Pradesh, where they had another system, which is the big day meal, is also fed to the Anganwadi children, so that there's no duplication of work. I found that the curry was cut up, the chawal was uncooked. The point is that we have tried every which way of trying to feed the children. In some states, they give it to NGOs, women, mothers groups, small little NGOs, and the food is like they do in Bihar, like they do in Chhattisgarh, and the food is uniformly bad. Some places they give to contractors, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, and the food is equally bad, if at all it's made. Some places they give it to, I don't know, there are so many combinations of deliverers, service vehicles, of people who make and are supposed to deliver. And somehow we haven't been able to grapple with the fact that the food itself, the ingredients themselves are bad. I have suggested time and again, and I mean, I'm just saying this because I'm off script now, but I'm just sharing my experiences with you, that A, we should, in the PDS system, we supply food. Now this child gets fed whether by Akshay Patra, which is a nutritious meal, or by anybody else, maybe not so nutritious meal. But the point is that two other meals that the child has to have at home. And that food that is cooked by the parents is usually from the PDS system. And the PDS system also supplies, perhaps, material that needs upgradation. And one of the things that I've suggested again and again is adding millets to the PDS system, so that people can buy them at subsidized rates. And I would like to everybody here to join me in that urgency. I've asked the food ministry, who's now headed by a very intelligent woman who used worked with me, and I've asked her again and again if she can bring millets in, so that A, growing millets uses much less water. We have, I think, how many, not less than about 30 or 40 different kinds of millets in this country. And firstly, it uses much less water. Two, it's completely nutritious, any kind, whether bajra or anything else. It's completely nutritious. And three, it's grown, they are all disappearing. All the various millets that we have are disappearing because they're not coming to the market properly. So if government could buy them and allow the people of India to buy them, they would be cheaper than white rice and white atta. They would be much more nutritious. And that child, when he eats in his own house, would get an opportunity to eat a nutritious meal, rather than depending totally on that one midday meal, which, no matter how good it is not going to solve the entire calorific problems of the day. Another thing that I have devised which I've been working on for the last 2 years, is let us suppose we stop talking. I'm now not talking about midday meal. Midday meal is fine. It'll go well or not well. It's an organized thing. There are problems with that as well. For instance, we pay the people who cook 1,000 rupees a month and then actually expect them to not pinch or not eat sound food. Two, we make it so, we're so strong about feeding the children that often the principal of these schools sits down with all the teachers and they just simply cook. You must have seen that yourself. That more emphasis now is put on cooking than on teaching, because that's where the government emphasis is. Feed. Children cannot study on an empty stomach. I agree totally with that. But I'm not talking about the midday meal. I'm talking now about the Anganwadi system of feeding children from 0 to 2, when the neurons are developing. And one suggestion I have had, and given to just about everything the government, and if Mr. Gandhi was here, he would hear it again from me, which is let's stop talking about food and talk about nutrition. I learned this from a very clever Secretary of Health and Nutrition in Dehradun. I forget her name, but she came to see me, and the government of Dehradun, the previous government, towards the end, had done pilot study and had taken severely malnourished children, SAMs as they are called, and fed them a combination of peanuts, millet, sugar, and about 8 or 9 different things, all mashed together, enjoyed, and put them into buckets and given them enough 600 calories to 1,000 calories per packet. And the packets were like salt and pepper packets. Now, they had done it. A, it tasted delicious. And two, it was completely nutritive. They had listed what the protein was, how much magnesium, phosphorus, potassium, whatever, calcium, and had managed to get a balance. Now, this is still lying in my office. We're showing it to different states, getting them to do it. And they then did a pilot study to show whether it worked or not. So they did it on SAMs in Uttarakhand. And the results within 3 months were amazing. Severely malnourished children, teeny weeny children, 2 kilos, 2.5 kilos at the age of 6 months, suddenly put on two kilos or double their weight in 3 months, or put on more than that. So they've got all the data. The point is that I am now trying to persuade all the states, because I can't do anything directly. I can only give them money. But what I have done is repeatedly called them, repeatedly spoken to each minister, gone myself, and showed them the Dehradun Uttarakhand results, and said that if we can just stop feeding food and stop the emphasis on being on teeth chabaling, basically it's a sensory experience. I eat, and just give them this packet and let them pour it into water, juice, milk, whatever. And along with that, give them 2 biscuits, because Britannia did a study, I think Vinita Bali did a study about 6 years ago, in which she found that if you fortify 2 glucose biscuits, which cost 10 paisa, then within 3 months you can get rid of anemia, which is a major, major part of malnutrition. So if we gave them these packets and we gave them these 2 biscuits along with it, we got them straight from any company or government makes it themselves in the States, whichever. But we could actually, in 1 year, bring down malnutrition severely by simply saying this is no longer food, this is now medicine, it's nutrition. And instead of using the Anganwadis, because the Anganwadis are at a distance from the walking mother, the pregnant mother, the lactating mother, and the little baby. So many of them don't have homes of their own, even though every year since I've been here, we're making 70,000 to a lakh new Anganwadi centers. But you still, many of them are in schools, many of them are in rented places, which are at a distance. So the amount of energy spent by the mother and the child in walking does not get compensated by the kind of food they get. So if we took these packets out of Anganwadi hands and gave them 30 at a time every month on the first of each month to each family that had a baby and had a lactating mother or a pregnant mother, we would get an immediate, within 3 months, we could see the difference. And if we could map it every inch of the way, it would also remove all the stealing. Because on each packet, if you had not for sale written, and you had government of whichever state it was, then it doesn't have a market anymore. So it would be difficult to steal it, it would be difficult to misuse it. And I believe that it would be a way forward. Maybe Akshay Patra can design, you know, take on this onerous duty of taking a state, persuading them, and then making these, we can give you the recipe and you can tinker with it. So that it reaches the same place, 600 calories to 1000 calories. And we then give it, I mean, I'm quite happy if you do it, or if, but anybody does it, you know, anybody who's got a system going. And if you'd like to try it, I'd be happy to collaborate with you in pushing it to the States. Thank you for giving me this time. I again congratulate you, and I congratulate the companies that have come forward. You are doing a great, great job, and I'm sure you'll be